Hey guys, Aaron here. Hope you're having a great Tuesday. I've got Wayne with me today. And we're going to give Donkey Kong Country a go. It's a classic. What was it, 1994 on the Super Nintendo? So we're going to stick it on two-player team. See how far we can get. And we might carry on, you know, another week.
Well, the thing is, we've done two and we've done other ones in the past. And they are all considerably harder than this.
Well, that is a good point. We never did finish off number two, did we?
It was only a few. Oh, do you know what? You know why I came in here? Because nearly every Donkey Kong Country game, when you go in the first... Yeah. This is pretty much the only...
Oh, only one you did.
Okay.
Sneaky.
There's always one at the start of every Donkey Kong game.
Terry, welcome. How are you today? And there's a few other people... in the chat, I still think. Future Perfect Gaming, welcome. Spider King. Welcome to the stream. So yeah, I'm leaving Wayne in control of Donkey Kong here. I was talking to Wayne before the stream started, trying to figure out how long it would actually take to get through this. So maybe a stream or two, we'll see. This was definitely the one that I played the most. Well, it's the only one I really played until we played the other ones the other week or other month.
Really missed the cave, really.
Where was the cave?
I think it's on this one. It's nothing to do with percentages and stuff. It's literally just an extra life.
Oh, okay. That's something. They did go a bit crazy with the collecting.
Oh yeah, I mean the thing is, number two really kicked it up a notch, and three I really enjoyed it, no weather. But yeah, this was the first game. It was great for its time. Remember the big guys you can't kill as many.
Okay, I will keep playing. I remember actually when this was first announced. Everyone thought it was an N64 game. Because it looks so good, but...
Compared to some games, it was pretty impressive.
There you go, back on the team. My bad.
Oh dear.
Well, I guess that was having Diddy there, it kind of... That's why he bounced back. How you doing, Terry? Don't think I've spoken to you too much lately. Hope you're doing well.
Can't believe you died like that. Actually.
Can't believe I died like that, really. I usually do stupid things like that. Yeah, a lot of people have been playing the new Switch game. A lot of the Mario streamers anyway have all been doing it, so it was just more justifying the cost of buying that game when it's really not that much different than the Wii U game. I thought I actually got hit then.
So did I, that was
I nearly went for the G at the top.
I think the thing is as well is these levels are a lot shorter than later, like from the second game onwards as well, considerably shorter.
I mean, when I originally played it, I thought it was a good game. I didn't think it matched up to some of like the Mario stuff, but it was just really different.
I think that's the thing with the collectibles and all the stuff with 2 and 3 and stuff. That's where it sort of kicks it up. To
yeah, I think the game hit its stride in the second game, definitely. This one definitely is a lot more maybe linear.
Oh, yeah.
A bit easier, which isn't a bad thing, I guess, but if you want a long game, number 2 or 3 is probably the better ones, but
it's like anything, I mean, in a sequel you expect more bigger well, yeah, from.
Yeah, you'd be disappointed if it wasn't, so.
Still, it was one of the few games that was sort of rival for Mario. You know, there's a lot of rubbish 3D platformers as well.
Nice. Terry, yeah, I've just been crazy busy lately. I'm trying to get everything I can, you know, get done. And then focus a bit more on the channel, I think, once that is all sorted. I mean, it's getting pretty warm as well, so I kind of want to go out a bit more rather than getting stuck in the room. And well, I wouldn't say getting stuck in the room, but, you know, working on videos. Yeah. Exactly, it's been crazy warm some days.
Taking Leo back, I think the hottest it was 2 days ago, 27 it got to.
Oh, really? Just, that's
pretty hot for over here.
Yeah.
Ecuador!
Oh, he comes back.
Yeah, he bounced.
I might just
wait,
hang back for that. What is that supposed to be?
Octopus.
Is it an octopus? Funny little
special
octopus.
Spinning, yeah, spinning backwards.
See, I remember these levels quite well because I did one of those Retro Monday videos. And one of them was the competition for this. So it was just getting through it as quick as possible.
Music survival Mario's when it comes to
what is it with music and you know from Mario sorry water music, you know, from Mario Donkey Kong, it's just so relaxing, sounds great.
I think that's just the thing of this game for its age was the quality of the music and graphics and stuff for its age.
It's the eye. Right, can't take it with us. Hey there, true pixel gamer, bananas underwater, totally normal. Well, it is in this universe anyway. who else we got? Ranier, Play Jogos, welcome from Brazil. Nice one.
At least take a hit so I can.
I was going to say it's.
You're doing quite well here. Because again, this thing that changes later on in the second game and stuff. If you complete a level, why start the next one? If I complete a level, you complete it. Then you can swap to a phone. This one, I think you just keep going until you.
Oh, really?
Hit.
Well,
well, it's inevitable you're going to get hit.
I was going to say, probably once you get the pan back, you're going to have it for a while.
Oh, we can get three golden. No, that's fine. Get three golden things. You get like loads of like extra.
Oh, okay, things, that's
so
cool.
That's fine.
We were talking the other week, actually. There was someone who made like an animation of, was it Donkey Kong Country 2?
Yeah,
it looks amazing.
Like, what you could do if you used like Unreal or something to do remake.
Oh,
the
There you go.
Oh, I said to you, innit? Donkey Kong Country 1, 2, and 3, all made in, like, HD. Sold as a, you know, that would sell phenomenally well.
Go down very
well. Or remastered orchestral music or something.
Because don't get me wrong, the game still looks decent, but it definitely is showing its age compared to anything.
That's what I mean. Unreal 4 engine, fully redone trilogy. You could easily charge full price for it. I'm sure people would pay for it.
I think really. It's usually me that dies that quick. Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, like the Crash Bandicoot show, you know, that trilogy did really well.
Done exactly like that, yeah. One, two, and three. Yeah, that would be absolutely amazing.
It's the same one again. Oh, fair play, True. Nice one. Been working on that for a while, haven't you, sir? Nice one. I tell you what, I've not picked up Link to the Past for so long.
Yeah, he's not playing that.
Oh, really? It's a good one to start off with. I still got really good memories of Link's Awakening. There's apparently been rumours as well that that's going to get a remake. Or kind of like what they did with Link to the Past with A Link Between Worlds. Really enjoyed that one. Is it really nice? It's diabolically hard and unfair. Okay, I'll take it back. It's horrendous by the sounds of it. Areas like this are going to slow us down a bit, I think. What is it, just a case of trying to collect all of them? Like?
No, every 100 to life.
Right, okay. Dan, yeah, we were just talking about the music. Pure nostalgia. There's just something, to me at least, right? What was that? that was just, we won't even go there. There's just something about 90s gaming music that, you know, catchy stuff. Don't get me wrong, nowadays the music is great, but it's very much like a film, like a...
Yeah,
sound, you know, a big like epic soundtrack. Not really as catchy, I find. But
not even dying through whatever we're dying through. Like such, what I've done there was running with one of his necks.
Right,
run and run rather than run and jump.
Okay, well I'll try and redeem myself. Tomb Warrior, you know what, at the time being, I'm not even thinking about it. It's not a ban or anything, is it? It's just something I need to be aware of going forward. Yeah, one of the mods, Major Scowl, he went to a big retro show over in Norway, and I think it was David Wise, he basically, there you go, get him. He was the composer of a lot of music for the Rare games.
I thought he carried on that way. I forgot he reversed.
But yeah, David Wise, great composer. The music might be, I'll turn it down.
And the bosses are considerably easier.
Tomb Warrior, let me know what you think. Let me know if it sounds a bit better. The thing is, we do have sound coming out of the monitor as well, so it might seem a little louder than usual. Ah, oh, classic.
Frog game.
It's kind of crazy as well, they've dropped all of these enemies from like the newer games, haven't they? I guess Rare Road.
Yeah, but again, they've been... Each game's been relatively fresh. This isn't a bad thing. We've lost a few guys and we're still like double the original starting list.
Very true. the game audio is great, awesome. Just as long as you guys can still hear the quality music, it's all good. Right, let's jump over. Really?
Yeah, I thought you'd jump over. I thought you might be able to get over it.
Maybe we should have done a race on this one. I might have actually had a chance.
As I say, as a platformer goes, it's good, but you can see what I already mean how much considerably easier than the second game is.
I was going to say, I can't imagine getting through the minecart section straight away. We shall see. The favourite piece of music in the game, True Pixel, for me at least, is the water music. That's the only one that has really sort of stood out,
and
apart from the
what's on the boat music in the second game and the last boss.
Well,
in
this one, the last boss.
The one with on the boat music. Oh. It's in the second game more, but it is in this game as well. Oh, you got halfway.
The cave music from this level is the factory music from Donkey Kong Country Returns. Did not know that. Crazy Kong, welcome. Hope you're doing well today. Oh, really, Dan? Oh, fair play. Yeah.
The door is there.
I was going to say this is going a bit too well.
That was literally the end.
Okay, there's still a Kremlin. Yeah, I mean, Dan, watching your Simpsons video, I've just kind of like got the knack to play it again now. Used to love that game and Tales Arcade.
See? Easier done. You don't reach it perfect time and you just go off the edge.
It's what the old platformers were like though. All about pixel perfect timing for jumps.
Cough, cough, cough.
Yeah, Dan, I know what you mean. I sometimes sit down to do a video and then something happens and have to delay it a little.
Mm-hmm.
How? How is that even possible? Getting up the tracks there.
Okay. I as well. That's I fine. Normally always do.
Watch out for that last one. Nice one. Yeah, Terry, I don't know what to say about that. So many people seem to have moved over to Twitch as well lately. Maybe it is down to the chat lag. I can fix that. It just means people can't go back into the stream. I don't know if it affects the quality at all, but...
Whoops. Whoops-a-daisy.
Oh, Dan, the amount of fun I used to have. Do you remember when I built my old arcade machine with MAME on it? And we would just like play all night. I think that was how, before I met Dan Wright, one of my other friends... Great. One of my other friends told Dan, oh, you should come up to Aaron's house. He built an arcade machine for his room. And to my knowledge, Dan was like, hell yeah. Yeah, Metal Slug's a good game, especially with MAME. Close. Okay. Just jump over there. Yeah, it was a sad day when I binned it a few years ago. Just been sitting in storage, so it was way too big. Great fun at the time, but the arcade sequel I was trying to build, didn't really get very far with it. Don't get Squawks the parrot, do you, in this one?
You kind of do. I think he's like,
Isn't he a torch, or...?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's all coming back to me.
So you can jump on bees as a frog, which is amazing.
Yeah.
Makes life considerably easier.
This time next week, I guess a Nintendo Direct will already be over. About,
oh, cool, yeah.
See what they've got to reveal for the rest of the year. You're doing this one. So what is it? Just you want them all to say stop?
Yeah, if it's on go and they touch you, you die.
You're dead, right.
You have a certain time to get from one to another.
thought it was going to be a bit more strategic, like sometimes you have to keep it on and other times off.
Oh, it gets more and more difficult though.
I see what you were trying to do.
You want to hit it as you land, but yeah.
You got the checkpoint, it's all good. Can you just kind of
roll it quick, and then jump?
I was gonna say, can't you just avoid them completely?
No. You won't be able to avoid them.
You could have just avoided them. I don't think it was necessary to get more. Does that randomly change as well?
No.
It is always like that. Yeah, quite a lot of the things you're doing with the tyres, I don't really remember doing, so... We've already spoken about it before, but it's like when you're young anyway, you get a game, you tend to play it a lot more, don't you? Multiple times.
Especially if you've had to spend like 3 months pocket money to get a game.
Yeah, exactly. I remember saving up to buy The Lion King on the Super Nintendo. £50.
Yeah.
It was not worth £50. Not at all. Did we play Donkey Kong Country Returns, Terry? I can't remember. think it might.
No, it's return. No, we've done the Wii U one.
We just did the Wii U one, right?
Yeah, that's another game.
Well, we seem to have covered all the other Donkey Kongs, so.
Number three.
Donkey Kong 3.
Oh,
I don't think you are going to make it.
Number 40. No, that's fine.
Ditch it.
Just go, walk through it, I don't know if that says you've completed 8 levels, not done 3.
Oh, we've got a boss. True. It doesn't spring to mind. You might need to remind me what you're doing. Was it a stream?
Two worlds in half an hour. So yeah, there's no way you would have done this on.
Oh, we'd still be on the same world. How many worlds are on this one?
6, 7.
I tell you what, the snow world as well, I think that's a great one, especially all like the snowflakes coming down around you. It's commentary, okay, fair play. Quite like the fact you have to rebound off some of the other enemies as well to get that height. True. Explain it a bit more then. So, you're doing commentary of another channel, did you say? Or you're commentating over a game? I'm a little confused right now. Okay, I will try and check it out if I'm not too busy on a Saturday. Mario seem to have time limits, but a lot do, yeah. A lot of people kind of find that stressful, they're going up against a time limit. Try that again. This level always kind of reminded me of Ewoks. Did you ever see that old Ewoks cartoon where they all lived up in trees? Maybe the movies did as well.
Fair enough. I can see what you mean though.
Yeah.
Jumping it in time.
Okay. Yeah, I guess it's down to the fact, Terry, that, you know, with Mario games, it's, to most people, it's about exploration. You look at the Sonic games, right, and it's all about, well, the earlier ones, anyone just dashing through levels. Whereas the Mario games, I always preferred them because, you know, you could explore around, things like that. Same, pretty much the same place.
No,
the 2D style or the side scrolling ones always seem to have a time limit, whereas the 3D ones don't. So
okay, that was bizarre.
The fact you just died. Oh. Yeah, I didn't click that. Yeah, you had to time that.
Oh dear.
Well, it's kind of good that it's somewhat tricky at least.
Every time you jump in them, you die.
Yeah, well, it's probably a good idea I don't jump in them.
At least I can do them. Do you know what? We've got three lives.
I'll do it this time. Thank you. looks annoying.
Savey thing.
I can't remember how what to go back to a save point or
that, yeah, well we saved a while ago, so
right, okay, we might try
just
that.
Do a restore point just in case.
You got the control, so press sort of down.
Down.
Why? Can't take it for granted, a lot of games just auto-save, so...
Yeah, otherwise I would have gone back before this go and saved it, because you can, it's just you have to go back and save it, which you've got.
Right, yeah.
You can easily just go back and save, once you've got saved, which you've got. It's just, and then if you die you get more lives, so it's not a problem. Just, yeah, like, so we kind of get spoiled now with auto-save.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Good.
So what we're gonna use to save.
Yeah, yeah, well we need to go back and save it, otherwise. Right. Well once we've saved
push
it,
down,
we can
and load it. That's it. Just press the button. Load and start.
Once it's saved, it'll be fine. It's just going to save for ages. Is this Lithuania? Oh, it's just... Oh my god. It's not even hard, it's just timing.
So this is nice. But it's looking a lot better than the previous times.
Oh, no.
So you collected the G. You might as well load it back up.
Oh, that was so unfair. That was it. Oh.
That's ridiculous. Michael, hey there. I could never figure out how Rare came to the conclusion that a mountain gorilla and a spider monkey are related. Are they related? Not too sure about that.
That was the end there.
Well, it wouldn't be the first time we got right to the end of the stage. It's all gone a bit wrong. It's the nephew, right, okay. Yeah, okay. Well, I know they've both got Kong as a surname, but I wasn't 100% sure on their relationship. Right. Oh, it works. Nice. You know, I won't worry about that. Awesome.
No, really, that's how close I was. Right.
Okay.
Go to Funky's
so
Flight.
We might as well say.
No, that's not. That's Funky's Flight. But
oh, okay.
Go in there.
Do you play as Funky Kong in the new one then? Is that the...
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the extra character. Yeah.
Oh, that's his first time I've been here.
You can tell the language he's using is definitely 90s. Okay.
Oh, it's just going out of circles.
Yeah.
Well, there you go, you can jump in the barrel or something. Just go back to the last level.
That one?
Yeah, that's fine.
That's so good.
Yeah, can be.
I can't remember, do the other games you have to trade to get...
Yeah. Just don't know.
Yeah, I think it's so.
Yeah, because no, that's going back out of it. That normally there's a button that makes a noise, because that's not done anything. You didn't push a button in there, you pushed stars. You didn't push
A. Well, I was pressing... Press A.
A.
Did
okay,
that before.
Okay, maybe I should do that. Okay, back to Funky's then.
Very true, Mike. I don't know exactly. There's so many different Kongs. I don't know what the relationship between them all is. But...
Now at least if we die, everything we've done is safe.
Excellent. Hopefully come back with some extra lives as well.
I mean, you can go back and save it any time, it's just remembering you can do it.
Yeah. I remember, was it the 90s, maybe early 2000s, there was like a Donkey Kong animated cartoon. I remember watching a little bit of it, it was weird. I'm surprised.
Yeah, I vaguely remember that, actually.
I'm surprised they haven't really tried to do much more with the... Donkey Kong franchise, it seems pretty popular, so. Hey there, Leon, how are you doing today? Poopa, welcome! How are you? I reckon if they do make this Mario movie, Donkey Kong's got a sharp in it somehow.
Oh god, yeah.
I remember seeing Donkey Kong and Donkey Kong Jr. on Saturday Supercase in the 80s. Wow. I wasn't even aware of that. The only things I kind of remember were the Mario Brother show.
Oh, God.
I just remember that show.
Yeah, it was, liked watching that.
Really, it's all on Netflix now, I hear. At least the American one, but I just thought that cartoon was, how to put it nicely, it wasn't very good. And you had the Zelda one as well. And
oh God, that was
excuse me, princess.
Just wait back. Wait. Okay.
Yeah, that cartoon was amazing. It probably was better than the Mario one, but none of them beat Captain N, the Games Master. Classic. Even though it was a very weird show, but it was quite fun. Super K was early 80s, fair play. Yeah, I have no recollection of that. The thing is, in the UK as well, even the Mario Brother one. Now, I can't really remember. I don't remember watching the cartoon that often, but apparently it was only in America where they had the bits with actual Mario and Luigi live action. I could have sworn they used to do that in the UK, but from what I read up, no, it never happened.
Mario World was a bit weird as well.
Yeah, Mario, I only ever watched one or two episodes. One of them had Yoshi in it going to a ghost house.
Yeah, Yoshi was kind of annoying.
His voice was horrendous.
Yeah.
Not what I was expecting Yoshi to sound like at all. I guess at that point Nintendo really didn't mind too much. They were still quite early on in the game. Now they're a bit more protective. Terry, I think I recently saw the Donkey Kong cartoon as well. It was weird.
Yeah,
it was weird. But for one of the early, you know, fully CGI games, CGI cartoons, it wasn't too bad. I mean, there was one called Reboot that I used to love.
Yeah, they've done a reboot of Reboot, and I've really enjoyed it.
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure whether to give it a go yet.
I've watched it through, I've really enjoyed it. But
well, maybe I'll give it a go. It's just some things you should leave, you know, for good memories, and I'm not too sure if that's one that I want to ruin. I don't know, you've said it's good.
20 minute episodes, there's only about 10 episodes.
I think it's more the fact it's live action, whereas the original reboot was all CGI.
Well, in the computer world, it's all CGI.
Oh, really? Okay. Okay. Oh. Go on, man.
Yeah, apart from their faces and the machines, everything's CGI in the game.
Yeah.
I've seen the real
world. Maybe if that's the case.
They basically put fiends on and go into the game.
Might as well say.
Oh yeah, yeah. They go into the like cyberspace.
Mainframe.
Yeah, they go into it all. But yeah, they're like human, the world's first human guardians. And yeah, I mean the Megabyte and all of that's in it.
Oh, that's good, that's good. The Chuckle Brothers should have done Mario and Luigi.
They do remind me of them too, to
yeah,
be honest.
Yeah, that could work. That could definitely work. Yeah, no, I've not really thought about it like that before. In Captain N, Simon Belmont was a jerk. Mega Man was mega annoying. Pit was called Kid Icarus, and yeah, that was my only issue with that show. For whatever reason, they changed all the characters quite a bit. As you say, Simon Belmont, he was nothing like the games at all. Mega Man was a different colour, which always confused me. He's green in that, where in the Mega Man games he was blue. But the main thing was, at that point, I didn't really have a Nintendo system, so I didn't really know the characters that well, so it didn't really bother me too much. And they brought Game Boy in as well at some point. He was quite a cool character, I thought, but by all means, it wasn't a great show, but it was, I found it enjoyable anyway.
You now have like this human character that like threatens Megabyte to like delete him, so he's like, he's in this world controlling Megabyte and stuff in this world, so whatever happens in the real world essentially affects the real world. And that was terrible. Right, concentration
time.
But then the first Mortal Kombat and stuff like that, and there are game films that were quite good.
Yeah, I mean, the Mario Brother was definitely an exception of being a terrible film.
Leon said Street Fighter as well.
Oh, I can't even watch that again. I remember watching that once. Stupidly, I watched it once more. I thought, I'll give it another chance. I'll never, ever be able to get that time back. It was just it was rubbish. Did you like it?
No.
That's good. It was...
Fantasy VII Advent Children was great. Yeah, there have been a few.
Advent Children was okay. I was very confused.
Yeah, but you never played the game through fairly.
Yeah, but... Oh, can you turn that... O2 are really bugging me. How do I get across?
Well, clearly they're jumping.
Yeah, it's fine.
It's not empty for that. Oh man, that was some speedy. Oh, we killed him, nice one. I gotta say careful, he's really fast, avoid him, and you killed him.
Oh, you got, was it Grumpy Car? Cranky, sorry.
Oh, what the hell?
Yeah, I watched the new Tomb Raider film the other day.
Oh, of course.
To be fair, right, it was okay at times. The story wasn't great. That's all I'll say if you've not watched it. I still think there's so much more potential to a lot of gaming movies, but for some reason they either get really bad script writers.
The best thing to do is to have the company that makes the game make the movie.
Yeah, but sometimes, you know, other game companies have had involvement in it and it's not really gone the way they wanted. But yeah, I think that would be better than giving it to your bowl or something.
Go and save it.
And then wrecking it. I definitely plan on a few games in the near future, Thierry. that probably would do the same job.
Well, obviously you got the same studio doing it, but Dudo, isn't it, what they call it? Minions, isn't it, doing Mario now?
Yeah, Illumination,
see.
Yeah.
We'll see. Fishy up the bum. Yeah, just got to be careful with them.
I tried. Wasn't it Dennis Hopper? I'm sure that rings a bell. He was a guy who played Bowser. Well, let's be honest, it wasn't Bowser. It was a guy in makeup and a spiky haircut that looked ridiculous. So,
it's
that film. Is,
that was...
There are people that get some enjoyment out of it. I definitely know a couple of people in real, well, off stream, that enjoy it. So
it's sometimes funny to watch of just how bad it is.
Don't get me wrong, I don't think it's the worst movie out there. You know, it's watchable at least. It's terrible, but you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. If I was that desperate to watch something, maybe it would do, but whereas you, there's other gaming movies, Alone in the Dark. Yeah, you can't pay me enough to watch that again. I don't even know if I made it all the way through. Same with Street Fighter. Yeah, Mike, totally agree. Okay, that didn't go
for fail.
Yeah, I totally agree. So many games nowadays are more like movies in their own rights. Do we actually need movies based on them? Probably not. Games with so much of a story anyway, like Last of Us, right? That story in the game is great. It works well as a game. Whereas they turn it into a film. I don't think it would go as well. The whole taking part in the game itself is what why I love that game so much. So but they'll keep trying every time. It probably won't go to plan.
Just go.
Yeah.
Down, up, in there. Oh,
still got life. Yeah, exactly. Sharknado. Again, I'm not particularly fussed about watching it, but there is people that enjoy that type of film. And trust me, I've watched some cheese fests in the past, so. The early Resident Evil animated ones, they're pretty good. The last one they made, I thought was pretty trashy, but the first one or two they did were good. And they got Leon Kennedy in as well, best character from Resident Evil. Talking about Resident Evil, there's hopefully going to be some gameplay of Resident Evil 2 Remake at E3. So, so looking forward to that game. That's a definite stream. yeah, definitely. Tomb Warrior. Sorry, I do apologise. I haven't got my headphones on, so I can't actually see on screen. If anyone hosts or subs, definitely say something. That'd be amazing. Cheers.
Just getting a third from my eyes going back across 5 miles. So it's worth it.
That's all good. Yeah, Mike, totally agree. That's a really good way of doing it. Just expand the lore or the universe of the game. Don't just try and copy the story because you know it won't work, so. It's kind of why I like Silent Hill movie. It didn't strictly follow the game, even though it kind of used similar characters and that, but. That one turned out okay. Right, so.
Up his butt. Well, no. No, never mind. No. Normal bump. Oh, no, just when he's yelling.
Oh, okay. You do it. Oh, so you need to hit 3 times in a row to get him red. Oh, he does turn back. Mm-hmm. Awesome. So what's that? Well, 4 in an hour.
That's what I mean.
That's pretty good going. Saving it.
Yes.
Good choice, Batman. Leon, maybe. I think Mario films work better as an animated. Yeah. If it was animated, fair play. I just don't think Mario games work. They don't work in real, you know, live action. This is kind of what I'm a little concerned about for the Sonic movie.
Yeah.
It just sounds like, what? And not only that, you've got the doc, what is it? Detective Pikachu. You've heard that one, haven't you?
Yeah.
Ryan Reynolds is in it, and who's the other guy? Ant-Man. Paul Rudd. It's like, what? But they obviously must...
Must
think it's alright.
Real life Sonic film.
That's real life Sonic. That just brings back bad memories of Sonic 06.
Yeah.
No one needs to see Sonic get off with a 20-year-old girl. It's just weird.
It was very, very weird, but hey.
It's more than
yeah, two Mario, it's a thing, apparently.
Yeah, you know what? Tomb Warrior. That was one of the first videos I did on my channel back in 2016. I did a bit of a discussion of the Sonic movie and the fact that it would be live action, and the kids will go and watch it, I'm sure, but it will probably end up terrible.
No, Liam, the new film, Mario film, is going to be animated.
Yeah, definitely. Seeing they released a trailer of Wreck-It Ralph 2. That was kind of like a gaming movie in its own right. The new one, I watched the trailer yesterday. It looks good, don't get me wrong, but it seems like they're trying to advertise too much stuff. It's like got Star Wars in it, with other Disney stuff. I'm not too sure about that. Yeah. Animated by the makers of Minions.
Yeah.
I'm hopeful.
Well, Shigeru's apparently got a lot of
input in it, so I'm hopeful that his input, will sort of change things up.
They know they can't bring out another... Because it's been a long time since they've even attempted something, so... Because the other thing is, I really hope it's successful, because I think if it is successful, then, we could see maybe some other...
Well, there's nothing. You may have been the one to mention this, Wayne, but a while ago we were kind of talking about this, and they could do like a Zelda movie,
Zelda Metroid,
and they could all come together like a bit of Avengers to like a Smash Brothers the movie. Like you have all their side stories.
There's such potential.
Yeah,
the Mario one does well, so I think they. It could be onto a big franchise scene here where
I think it could do well. It's getting to the point where the Marvel films, there's been loads of those. Star Wars as well. Star Wars,
I still think Zelda done right could be. I've always said could be an amazing film if it's done right.
What style would you prefer, the Zelda? A bit more of a realistic approach?
More realistic.
Or Wind Waker?
Man, in realistic, if they could do a Zelda film, I would love it on like Lord of the Rings caliber.
Yeah.
If they could do it, that's what I'm saying. Zelda has got the lore, the creatures, the stuff to be able to do that sort of caliber thing. Mario, no, like you said, I don't think would work. But Zelda, I think, has got the world that would work in a believable... It's not like they said they can't afford it.
Yeah, it's just, I think if that's, if they're going to try and keep all this stuff to animated, you got to have a bit of humour in it, I think. If it's live action, yeah, it would be good.
I think Zelda, that's what I'm saying, though. I think Zelda's got the right sort of universe that could work in, really. Like, if you do have a trilogy, like, that could probably compete with Lord of the Rings, easy.
I remember watching a few episodes of some TV show, Shannara Chronicles.
Yeah.
It was pretty much Legend of Zelda. You had the guy like Link, you had a princess, you had... it just reminded me so much. I only watched a few episodes, but maybe if they went in that direction where it got cancelled, so maybe not, but... You did it.
I didn't realize I was already off there. I used to have more lives.
Bonus. Golden rhinos. Nice. Leon, dunno. I would hope they keep his Italian accent. But the question is, will they keep Charles Martinet as the voice of Mario? That... I personally would prefer they did that, but being Hollywood, you would expect them to get a big name. They might get, I don't know, wouldn't surprise me if they got someone like Ryan Reynolds or someone trendy at the moment to do the voice. Good job we got 20. Well,
that's
nine knives, yeah.
Oh, you wanted to swap over to me, did you?
Yeah, don't know what happened there.
Okay.
that was well worth it, man.
Oh, dear.
That was well worth it. Very close with the time. Maybe, wait for it to... Oh, what? I was going so well. I was totally fired in the wrong direction.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, no, Mike, again, yeah, I think you are right there. It would get a bit grating. Just thinking back to Mario Sunshine when he actually has quite a few things to say. It's, comes off really cheesy. Maybe they could do something where it turns out he's just putting on a fake accent for the games. I don't know.
Same bit. Oh, you're so amazing.
I can't do anything.
You have to, yeah, when you take control, the moment you
okay,
have to jump.
Okay.
Jump. Right.
Detective Pikachu. I think they've been filming up in London. I'm not too sure when it's out, maybe this year. Excuse me?
Skills, boy!
And you moaned at me, really?
Yeah, they start that guy in like half a second. That was close.
Little faith in me. So you're telling me I've got to go back through this. Straight up.
Oh, no, you didn't
to the right.
Yeah, to the right. You didn't have to worry about that. Just come down. Like, oh.
I think that's the only thing that's been causing us some grief, the barrels here. Whoa! A little slidey.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah. See, why? Well, yeah, that's what my eyes. Because the problem is the snow blurring actually makes it a bit like my eyes are red raw. Oh, Jesus. Off to you. Oh, yeah. Wait for a second.
That's better, right.
Still on ice though.
Well, at least we're not getting pelted with snow. I'm not too sure how I'll get up there.
Like that, just
wait for it to.
So wait for it to go up. Boing. To the left. No.
Oh.
I'm afraid that's the wall.
Ah, what? Quite liking the music on this one.
It's more upbeat after the like lost up snow level.
Yeah.
Skills.
I'm trying.
Yay! Woo! Round of applause.
Anyone in particular?
I'm just taking with you.
Oh.
Skills
or lack of. Try that again then with a barrel.
Poor monkey, look how upset you made him.
He'll get another chance. Were there any other video games where you played as monkeys?
I remember there was
a game called Toki.
Ape Escape, yeah.
Oh, Ape Escape you played as a kid, I think.
Yeah, I was just thinking about that. Yeah. I gave the monkeys in.
I think Toki was good. I think they're remaking that, but.
Monkey Ball, yeah. Monkey Ball.
Yeah.
Monkey Ball. Can't forget Monkey Ball.
One of the probably best games with monkeys in. I think it's about time as well, there is a new Monkey Ball.
Yeah.
It's been a while now.
again, with the gyro controls on the Switch, that would work perfect. Oh.
Whoa.
Hold on.
Well, at least I got the checkpoint there.
There's a hole. I'm going to jump in it.
Why not? Someone's got it.
When it's close to the halfway mark or the mark point, it's that like that was, because then it's like, don't really waste any time. So that's what I had to redo. What? Oh, it's too late. Okay, well, the DK barrel was just there, though.
That was just in front.
No, to the left.
Going on. So is that me?
Up, yeah.
Eyes go down.
Just keep going to, as I said,
like wall jumping. It means the second number. Yeah, don't say. I just assumed there was some purpose of number two being
no.
there.
No. So jump to the left and over
like,
the wall.
Yeah. Like if it was Donkey Kong Country 2, right? Maybe having the two there would mean it's the second game. At least the snow's not as bad. Probably spoke a bit too soon.
Yeah, I think it gets worse again later on.
mean, the making of this is, it was quite interesting, really, because they actually rendered all of the Donkey Kong sprites, everything they rendered looks a lot better, and then they all saved them as individual sprites, and then so while it does look 3D, they are actually 2D. So yeah, so it was just quite good sort of watching that. I think it was on one of those old bad influences.
Oh, no.
Fail. Oh, the orangutans. That was like, if you had gone on Ninja Warrior with that.
I would have got like, I would have been cheered at for being such a funny fail. Yeah, but I mean, you've had more. Oh, see what I mean?
I don't know, actually. You had quite a few deaths near the beginning, man. What was... See what I mean? That is just...
Oh, God, man. I don't even... It's because you're making me laugh. That's what I blame. I blame laughing. Oh, yeah. Whoa, he killed the monkey.
Really? Now, that's kind of how you're supposed to... Whoa. Nearly ate my own words there.
Oh, dear. That was funny.
I don't think anyone questions how Donkey Kong or Diddy Kong just randomly appear in these barrels.
Animal cruelty.
I was thinking, is it Petter? They'd probably be on the case of this. You got this, man. Jump. Nice. One done.
Oh, dear.
We're getting through it pretty quick, I reckon. Now that looks like an octopus. Well, I see what you mean.
Spinning.
Turns around. Meant to do. Or not. I can't believe we haven't come across a checkpoint.
Checkpoint, probably just about there, but yeah.
There is a checkpoint. So it's a very big one.
Yes.
Okay. My bad. I guess that's one thing with it. I guess it's down to the older technology, but like compared to most games nowadays, the enemies kind of respond to you, whereas this, they just go about doing their own business, just like in a pattern. It would have been quite good if they actually did try and follow you around or something.
Again, okay, that was before we had the...
I mean, some of the games kind of did that to some extent, but... this was a pretty big one, so... Nice one.
Oh, geez.
The concentration.
That was on
it
that
was
one,
extreme.
Too.
Okay. Oh, was this the ad? Yeah, scores.
Yes.
Put you off, eh?
No, I thought I'd let you have a go.
Yeah, sure. I can't defeat
because it's
them.
So much harder for you.
Yeah. What was that? A bit of slowdown?
No, it just when they turn around.
I'm not even going to bother going for those.
that noise, yeah, that they all start making in the second and third game. Oh.
A bit too close, huh? Would you kind of want to see another 3D Donkey Kong? Like a full 3D, but...
If they could do it better than 64. I mean, 64 was one of the games that was good at its time, but it's got its age badly.
I think Donkey Kong 64, it comes way too late in the N64 life, really. They turned it way too much into a collector form. Don't you agree?
Yeah, but then so were every platformer around that
era. Yeah, but Banjo-Kazooie wasn't, you know. I think that was very similar to Mario 64. It did it just about right. Banjo-Tooie, I think they tried to do too much collecting.
Yeah, just trying to make love it... that sort of thing, so...
Yeah, but
you're not so much a collector.
No, I love collecting. Like, look at Arkham Asylum, right? Yeah. There's lots of collecting in that, and the original Tomb Raider.
Yeah.
I collected everything in both of those games. Both of the sequels, though, they just go too crazy on the collecting. There's, I don't know how far you got on Rise of Tomb Raider, but
that's 67%.
But when you have to literally stop all the time during a gunfight to pick things up, to me that's too much. Whereas the original, it just did it really well. I think some games, developers, they try and make them way too long to get people's money's worth out of them. But a lot of the time, they don't need to be long. As long as they're enjoyable, like a 5-hour game could be better than a 10-hour game full of collecting junk or any of that stuff.
Something wrong with the controller. Maybe jump off the edge.
Yeah, like I haven't heard that one before.
I do. I'm doing a Dave.
Did he try and use that line last week?
Oh, most memories.
Smash. I was actually well surprised last week at Smash. Did actually pretty good. Thing is, when you start to get quite same place, wasn't it? When you start to get quite good at a game, anyway, like. Previous times we play Smash puts me off just if you're doing bad, but with the new one coming out, I was talking to Wayne saying I wasn't really too sure about buying it, but I'm gonna wait till E3. It does look like it could be a lot of fun.
That jump.
Yeah.
DK battle right there. Come on, Aaron. You can do it.
You can do it. Like these two guys, is that like literally all they do every day? Jumping back and forth. Don't like this bit. It will happen, trust me. Oh no, we're good. I just wanted to prove you wrong
monkeys.
There.
Unhappy monkeys again.
Well, my bad. how many bees?
Three.
I want to time this so it's on its way back. Cracked it. Nice.
Yeah, dearie, definitely.
Okay, we got another boss.
Oh, naughty again.
I get to have first try. You can actually jump a little higher.
Yeah,
it's unfortunate.
Whoa, that was like across the whole map, wasn't it, that one?
Yep.
Yeah, it must have been the last hit then, that one.
Well, that time.
No, you still had a few to go. Six hits.
Really? Sure, it hit six times.
Super banana.
What's a beaver need bananas for anyway?
Because they're super bananas that make them super sized and give them. Yeah, there's okay. Some messed up story behind it.
Yeah, we probably should have done. Is this the last world?
No, this one I'm on one thing. Or maybe one more of that.
Was this the music you were talking about, Terry? The factory?
There is lots of good music.
I mean, it's quite good, actually, that they were even in future games. So where's that third one, isn't it?
Yeah, there's no point. There's one banana as well, isn't it?
No. It's not the music. Right, okay. Nice try. Can't even get to it. What's this actually gonna do for me?
I've got the O so far, but I swear there's something. Oh yeah, they're getting there, they'll use it there. Jump. No. That black bit there is something to open up.
Oh right.
Sure. Get up, yeah, so you probably need to get up to that. There you go.
He's looking at me funny. Scan all the oil can. Just like floating in the air.
Yep. Burn bar.
Must be pretty close to the answer. Do you know what was that?
1, 2, 3, then goes down. I forgot. Okay. It changes pattern there.
I've watched several videos that they tend to use music from other games, so.
Welcome back, Dan.
Hey there, Dan. Welcome back. Or in capitals, love it. Yeah, we're going to finish off about 8 o'clock tonight, so we'll see how far we can get into this world. If people want to see us finish it, to be fair, I've quite enjoyed playing it anyway, so we could come back to it. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. Maybe I haven't fully made my mind up what we're going to do next week for the E3 stream, because it starts at 5, but I probably will be doing a bit of a stream beforehand rather than after, but we'll see what happens. Cap lock fail. Yeah, Terry. Okay, fair play. We'll play through it. It would have been good to get it all done today, but it's just not going to happen. So.
No, but I reckon we only need one more.
Well, one more. Yeah, I reckon hour and a half. Shouldn't be too bad. He says. We've got 5 lives, man. I'm starting to get worried. Zila, welcome. Don't worry about it. It's absolutely fine. Hope you're doing well. Major Scout, welcome. How's it going? Yeah, we've been talking about the music of the game, actually. So, some classic tunes, David Wise, yeah. To be fair, we've got quite a long way through the game. Was it World 5, 6? You can do it. I love how games can be so random, and there's like no reason for these tires or cans to be floating in the air, but why not? It's a video game. Do that stuff. Games nowadays, you know, they try to make sense, whereas, yeah, a lot of the old games, you had weird stuff, like enemies that had nothing to do with the game itself, like totally out of place.
It's just about the game rather than having to have like all the sort of scientific reasoning behind it. Oh, that was amazing.
Yeah, exactly. Yes.
Now everyone wants an explanation for everything.
Yeah, yeah. Oh wow. Kind of reminds me of Mario Maker now.
Good jump on him.
Well, I thought just landing on him would do the job. Obviously, I was wrong. Yeah, Major, I was saying actually about David Wise that you'd gone to meet him at the Norway show. The stream's lagging
for him.
For yourself. You know what? It's lagging for me. We'll just continue. I have been, if you can hear me still, I've been having some issues with my internet, and I changed the router, which I thought fixed it. Not too sure. Obviously, it's still some kind of problem. Oh, you got no lag? Oh, okay, fair enough. It's good to know. Was it really worth it? Well, that would definitely make a change, because I'm used to getting a bit of internet problem during the streams lately, so all good. Apparently David still remembers you. I've spoken to several people who've been in contact with him. Apparently he cannot forget me. I find that pretty funny. What exactly happened at the show when you spoke to him? There must have been something you had done to make him remember you so much.
Took a poo on his desk, Cartman style.
Well, the thing was, David Wise, he actually did the Great Mighty Poo song, actually live, which was quite funny. I watched the video. Still remember when we all went up to the hill, West Hill, the Great Mighty Poo song. Good times. Lay, welcome. How are you today? You've just made like the last 10 minutes of the stream, so thanks for popping by. It's been a good stream. Enjoyed playing the game. Had some real good chats, actually. Always good. Who would have thought gophers would be so dangerous? Are they gophers?
You just see it going. I think I'm just like,
just yeah. A danger to myself, obviously. Okay. Well, that would be somewhat different, yeah. So that's cool. That's good that he remembers you anyway. Yeah, well, as you say, so many people probably come up to him just to sign the game cartridge. He's probably actually quite happy that someone has actually done something different. Because the music was what he made, you know, that the actual game was made by, well, maybe not hundreds of people, but the music, I guess, was pretty much all him. So to him, that's a bit more sentimental. Oh, your cat. Oh, nice one. Yeah, you're off out with your mum soon, aren't you? Which way am I going?
Down. Down.
Drop down. Come on.
Third time, I reckon your average survival is about 30 seconds.
I won't say anything.
No. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I
knew that was going to happen. I just knew it. You deserve that, man.
I did.
You really did.
I did.
All yours. Oh wow, what was that? Less than 30 seconds?
Yeah, I'm learning from the master.
Okay, one life left. That's not good. Major. Sounds like a great idea, definitely.
Do a doodah. Can you do it? That save point. May as well. Just down there.
Go for it.
It is saved.
Zila, have you actually made any tunes yourself? I'm assuming you have. Definitely should share them. Yeah, tomorrow you're going to drive to The Hague. Well, safe journey and all that. Hope you have a good time. That's it. Start. Try that again.
It's not even hard, that's the annoying thing.
Like, why's it taking so long?
Because we're special.
Speak for yourself. Xavier, don't worry. thanks for stopping by. Unfortunately, we're pretty much going to finish off soon, but we're definitely going to come back and finish this. Whether it's next Tuesday or not, I need to figure that out because of E3 and doing the stream for that. But I've got Tuesday off work, so I'm hoping to get a bit of a stream in before the E3 conference, before we do a reaction type thing. We'll see what happens, maybe get it, finish this off before something like that. Yeah. I think it's getting to the point of the stream now where we keep making stupid mistakes, but we got to finish this level at least. Zila, is it on YouTube or anything?
More.
I do want to get to have a quick attempt at least. Now we get 3 minutes. I think that was our last life.
Yeah.
Is it worth saving now?
Yeah, save it. Just so we do this level. Yeah. We'll get some more lives for next time.
Yeah.
So what do we do? Why?
Why? Go for it. LA, any plans for the week? Nothing really major. I'll be back streaming Thursday a bit of Fortnite. It's pretty non-eventful this week for me. Just work. Nice 4-day weekend coming up. So that should be good. That's definitely Mario Brothers. Bit more aggressive there. Try to grab it. go on, we're right at the end now. Well, what, the stage?
Yeah.
Well, we got to the final G, so. Do you want me to do it?
First of all, better this way.
True picks. Yeah, I think it's probably wise we take the controls off of Wayne there. Just for the time being.
Oh, God.
How was Avengers again, Leigh? Did you enjoy it the second time? We're going to leave it there, guys.
It's saved at that point.
It's saved. Yeah, exactly. We've can only come got back to it.
Nice, nice to do, so.
Yeah, well, we'll come back and get that done. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching, and I'll be back on Thursday, a bit of Fortnite with a few, well, two, three guys from work. So that should be good fun.
I'll try and join in if I can.
Yeah, if you can join in, that's all good, man.
Cool.
Yeah, it'd be cool. Yeah. Yeah, really enjoy playing that, actually, but need to go and get some food. See you guys, take it easy, and yeah, another time. Later. See ya. Bye.